The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 27 through 29, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 19th, 1966, in New York.
Jatkaroshi jadasnashi jadjuhoshi dadasi jat जब तपस्वी कौन थे पुरुष सताद मदर्पण हियर इज ए जनरल प्रिस्क्रिप्शन फॉर ऑल पीपल फॉर ट्रांसेंडेंटल रियलाइजेशन ऑफ कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस जस्ट करो व्हाट एवर यू डू इट डजंट मैटर सो डू इट फॉर कृष्ण. And how to do it, we discussed in the last meeting, that you are doing something, simply change the consciousness that you are doing for Krishna. Nobody is inactive. It is not possible. You cannot be inactive even for a second, because as living entities, our position is that we shall be always active. Don't you see, as soon as I am out of this body, the body has no more activity. All activity stop. Again, when I enter another body, my activities from the womb of my mother begin. At the age of 7 months only, the child becomes active. So, spirit soul is always active. So, all these activities should be adopted in Krishna consciousness. Jat karoshi, whatever you do. Subhasvai phalairivam mokshasi karma bandhane संन्यास जोरुक्तात्मा विमुक्त माम उपैष्यसी. नाउ हियर इज अ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन फॉर्मूला. व्हाट एवर वी आर डूइंग इट हैज गॉट सम रिएक्शन. इफ वी डू पायस एक्ट देयर इज गुड रिएक्शन. इफ वी डू इम्पायस एक्शन देयर इज रिएक्शन ऑल्सो. Every action has got its reaction. That we can experience in this material world, that if we eat more, the reaction will be that for 2 days there will be indigestion. Similarly, this material world is so associative that every action has got its reaction. But Krishna says that if you act in Krishna consciousness for Krishna, then there will be no reaction. Subhasubha phalai evang mokshasi karma bandhane. In the 4th chapter, we have discussed that what sort of work we shall do. That is prescribed. Yajnarthe karma annatra lukang karma bandhana. Karma bandhana means you become bound up by the result and reaction. But if you act for jagyarthe, jagyarthe means for Vishnu or Krishna, then there will be no reaction. Subha subha. Subha means good and asubha means bad. So reaction, either good reaction or bad reaction, you have to take this body. Suppose you are, as a result of your good action, you are going to take your birth in the Rockefeller family of America. That's all right. But so far your body is concerned, the body itself is miserable. Don't think that because you are getting your body in some rich family or in other higher planets, in the demigods planet, where you can have a long duration of life. But still, you have got the material body. And as soon as you get this material body, the reaction of the material body, threefold miseries, and the miseries of birth, the miseries of death, the miseries of old age, and the miseries of disease will continue. Because you are a rich man, so you are not immune from the material miseries. That will affect. Therefore, all these material affection will continue. Either you do good work, either you do bad work. So yet we say, Lord Krishna says, Subha Subha Palai Rivam Moksate. If you dovetail your activities in Krishna consciousness, then you become liberated from all reactions, either good or bad, transcendent. Because in Krishna consciousness, you are not achieving any future reactionary resultant. Your place will be transcendental, will be transferred to the spiritual world. Therefore, you are free from all reactions. Just this Bhagavad Gita beginning. Arjuna was thinking of so many reactions for his fighting. But when he understood that if I fight for Krishna, there is no reaction, then he fought. So here it is also clearly stated that if you act for Krishna, suppose now, ordinarily, the judge. Dadasijat means charity. Charity according to Karmakandya Vicha, creative activity. Suppose if I give you some charity, say $100 I give you in charity, the reaction will be that I will have to realize $400 from you. That is the law of nature. Besides that, if my money is accumulated in some impious activity, and if you take my money, you will have to suffer. You have to share my reaction. These are the laws of karma, very subtle laws of karma. So, now if you give charity for Krishna activity, then there is no reaction. Of course, there is reaction that is called transcendental reaction that you will gradually become elevated into Krishna consciousness. So, Dadasija. Therefore, everything should be done but Krishna. And if you do like that, then you will neutralize the actions and reactions. Subha Subha Palai Rivam Moksate. You become liberated. Sannyasa yoga yukta atma vimukta mam upaishyati. And this sannyasa, renunciation means to become free from the actions and reactions. That is called sannyasa. Sannyasa does not mean that simply taking this orange collared cloth. Sannyasa means to become free from the actions and reactions. Because in the material activities, we are always creating actions and reactions. That a certain stage of your life, it is recommended according to the Vedic standard of, order of society. One has to accept the sannyasa order so that he may be free from the actions and reactions. And how one can become free from the actions and reactions? Simply by acting for Krishna. Externally, it appears that you are doing some bad work. Still, it will have no reaction. It does not mean that we shall entail our activities with some impious motive. No. Of course, a devotee cannot do that. But in supposing that you have done something which is impious, which you ought not to have done, still it will have no reaction. Because the assurance is there. Rangtang sarupa vibhamo phaishami masuja. The Lord will save you from the reactionary result of impious activity. Sarva papa. Papa means sinful activity. So, a devotee never acts sinful, but supposing that he sometimes consciously or unconsciously does something, there will be no reaction. That is the point. Sannyasa yoga yuktatma vimukta mamu pashyasi. And so long you are not liberated from the actions and reactions, you cannot be liberated. Now, pious activities. Suppose in my whole life I have never done anything impious. I have done simply pious activities. The result of pious activities is janma isadya sutasrivi. By pious activities, in your next life, you can get your birth in a very highly respectable aristocratic family. Janma isadya, you can get great amount of wealth, and janma isha suta, you can become a highly educated scholar, or you can become a very beautiful, you have a very beautiful body. These things are the result of good activities. Result. Now, suppose I get all these things, that is not my liberation. But we are for liberation. We want to get out of this material contamination. So, good work or bad work, that will not lead me to liberation. The bondage is there. But if you act for Krishna, or you act in Krishna consciousness, then you are liberated. And liberated means you are at once transferred to the spiritual world. Mama Paishas. Mama means you can get me. You can get me. Samoham sarvabhuteshu name disyasya na priya je bhajanti tuma bhaktya maite teshu chapaham. The Lord says that I am neutral. God is neutral. Samoham sarvabhuteshu. Samata means this point we have discussed. Samo, how you, God is neutral. Samo. If he is Samo, Samo means neutral, then how we find different grades of people or different grades of species of life? That is Samatha. Now, I'll give you a crude example. Suppose I am a shopkeeper. I have got different varieties of goods. Now, if you pay me less, then I can supply you inferior quality of goods. Another customer is paying me and a good amount, then I am supplying you a superior quality of goods. Now, I supply to some customer inferior quality of goods, to another customer I supply superior quality of goods. Is there any partiality? No, that is not partiality. So God gives you result of your action, samo. He is impartial. If you do good acts, then you get good result. If you do bad acts, then you get bad result. That is samoham sarva. This is the common formula. The Lord says, samoham sarva bhuteshu name deshasina priya. It is not that somebody is suffering because God is envious upon him. No, God is not envious. He is suffering his own activities. The same example we can give. Just like a person is ordered by the high court to be condemned to death. He will be punished, death punishment. Does it mean that the high court justice is enemy of that particular person? No, he is not enemy. He has created such situation that he is condemned to death. The High Court judge is not responsible for that. He simply administers the, intricacies of law of the state. Similarly, there are agents of law, the material nature, and so many there are agents we do not know. And then in the Shastras we have the Jamaraj, or there is a Justice Department, everything is there. So, he is neutral. It is not that God is kind to somebody and unkind to some other. No. His position is always neutral. Samoham sarvahutesu name deshasi desha means anyone whom I upon whom I am envious. Of course, our nature is to become envious. Even to enemy or friend, even a friend, develops his material condition, economic development, then we become envious. That is one of the nature of the conditioned soul. Even my son becomes something greater than me, I become envious. So this is nature. So, but God has no such, crude qualities. He is not envious of anyone. Samoham sarvabhuteshu name deshasti na priya. Nobody is very dear to him, and nobody is an enemy. But, he says, especially, je bhajanti tumam bhaktya, anyone who is engaged in devotional service and Krishna consciousness, maite, he always remains with me. Maite, teshu cha api aham, and I am also with him. Just see, a devotee, it cannot be separated, an unalloyed devotee, he cannot be separated from God. Premajnana shrita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva hridayeshu vilopayanti. Premajnana, when you have got, you have developed love of God. This is quite natural. Just like you, love somebody. You love some person or you always think of it. That is quite natural. Anyway, that is the objective of love. But because our love in this material world is a perverted reflection of the love of God. Love can be applied only to God. In this material world there is no love. It is all lust. There cannot be any love. The word love can be applied only to God. So these are only perverted reflection, what is going on in the name of love. There is no love. So, the nature of love is this, that the lover wants every moment to see without any remuneration, without any return. That is real love. Real love is described by Lord Chaitanya. His love of God being expressed in one verse. My Lord Krishna, you embrace me or trample me down at your feet, whatever you like, you can do. And you make me broken-hearted by not being present before me, because lover wants to see his lovable object. But if the lovable object does not come, he becomes broken-hearted. The Lord Chaitanya says, I am trying to see you, but you do not come. That's all right. I am broken-hearted. But still I shall continue to love you. I cannot distract myself from this love. This is pure love. This is pure love. So, Krishna says, Jetu bhajanti maam bhakta, one who is entrapped in such love affairs with God, Don't think that God is forgotten. God is also thinking in that. Although you do not see, but you see, those who are advanced in spiritual consciousness, Krishna consciousness, they always see Krishna. Similarly, as the devotee sees always Krishna, similarly Krishna also always sees that devotee. This is reciprocation. Although he is neutral, he says, I am neutral, but he still like cannot deviate myself from my devotee. He is always thinking of me. This is his admission. There is another admission by Krishna about the gopi. The gopi loved him so extensively that Krishna admitted that I cannot return your loving dealing. I am unable. So please be satisfied with your activities. I cannot return. Now just see, God, who is so powerful, he fails to retract the loving objective of the devotee. Samoham sabhutesu name desasti napriya. Jetu bhajanti maam pritya. Pritya means with love. We should worship is not applicable to the Supreme Personality of God. The exact word is seva. Bhajanti. Here it is. Bhajanti. Whenever you find the dealing between the Supreme Lord and the devotee, the word is used, bhajanti. The bhajanti word cannot be translated into worship. Worship means puja. Puja. Just like a worthy gentleman comes, I give him all reception. This is called puja. That may not be love. That is only etiquette. But love is defined. So here it is said, jit bhajanti tu. Bhajanti means render service in love. When there is question of love, there is service. Without service, we have got practical experience. Suppose if I love somebody, and if I don't give him something, don't eat something or give him something eatable, then what kind of love is it? That is not love. Love means bhajanti, render service. That is love. That is the beginning of love. So even there is no love, if you, under the prescribed rules and regulations, if you simply render service, then you will develop love. Savanam Kirtana, the class which you are holding, that you are hearing, and I am speaking, this is the beginning of love of God. Unless you hear of God, Adu Sadha, you gentlemen, ladies, you come here with some faith. So this faith is the basis of developing love. Adu Sadhya Tatu Sadhu Sangha Tatam Bhajana Kriya Anartha Nirittishya. So, we have forgotten our relationship with Krishna. Therefore, there is no question of love at the present moment. But we can develop this love by this process. Savanam Kirtana. Bhajanti. Bhajanti means bhakti. Bhakti, the beginning of bhakti or devotional service is to hear. Is to chant and hear. Unless there is chanting, there is no question of hearing. Here means, somebody must be chanting. Either we chant with musical sound, or we chant by lectures of Bhagavad Gita. This is all chanting. And the others, they are hearing. So this hearing and chanting is the beginning of bhakti or devotional service. Here it is recommended. Jetu bhajanti maam bhaktya. Anyone who with devotion and love begins this devotion and service and hearing chant, sabanam kirtanam vishnu smaranam. Smaranam. Smaranam means remembering. Smaranam. Samanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pada Sevanam Archanam Vandanam Dasam Sakham Atma Nivedanam. So these are the nine processes of bhakti: hearing, chanting, remembering, offering foodstuff, cleansing the temple, and offering your earning, jatkarosi, jarjosi, everything, that's the process, dealing. They are not in activity. This is the bhakti. So, anyone who engages his service, his pranayana, siddhyavach, service to be rendered with life, with wealth, with words, and with intelligence. Service. No unintelligent man can serve the Supreme Lord. Krishna Dev Haje Seva Rachatu. Only the intelligent class of man, they can serve Krishna, not the unintelligent class. So everything should be done with intelligence, buddhi. Prana Yatri Dhyā, Dhyā means by intelligence, Dhyā and Vāca, by words, by your money, by your life. So this is the reciprocation of dealing, of devotional service with Lord. And if there is any devotee who is constantly engaged in such reciprocation of devotional service, God will never forget. As He is always unto me, similarly, I am also unto Him. So there is no question of disappointment. Salpamabhi yastadharma sutrayati mahatubha. If you do little thing for the service of the Lord, it is noted in the notebook of Krishna. Don't think that your labor is going in vain. Everything you are, whatever you do sincerely, that is noticed. It is clearly stated here. Teshu tema. As they are always constantly thinking of me, similarly, I am also constantly thinking of me. How he can make further development? How he can come to me very quickly? How he can be free from all contamination of the nature? He'll give it intelligence. That is stated in another place, you'll find in the 10th chapter. Hisam satadyuktanang bhajatang pridipurvakam. Those persons who are always engaged in love and devotion in my service. Buddhi yogam dadamitam. I give them intelligence. Because intelligence requires. A fool cannot make progress in Krishna consciousness. Only the intelligent person. And that intelligence is supplied by God. He supplies. Dadami buddhi yogam tam. I give him such intelligence. What kind of intelligence? Jenama upajantite, by which he can quickly come to me. Therefore, our duty is to engage ourselves in Krishna consciousness. There are preliminary rules and regulations, and if we follow, follow those principles, it is not very difficult thing to see God or to become acquainted with God intimately. God is very cheap if we adopt the means. Vedeshu dullava adullava atma bhakto. Adullava, adullava, very cheap. To whom? To the pure devotee. But to others, those who are, mongering in philosophical speculation and manufacturing something, some hallucination, it is not possible to have relationship with God. But adullava, atma-bhakta, is very cheap to the pure devotee. So our duty is to become pure devotee by practice of this Krishna consciousness. And this is not at all difficult. He is chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. If you chant, you realize how you are making progress, and gradually Krishna is within you, God is within you, He will give you intelligence that you do this way, you do that way, everything will be clear, and the result will be Tattadeham punarjanmanayati mamiti. After leaving this body, he'll come to me. Then your human life is perfected. Follow this system. Thank you.